Hey YouTube, it's Nurse Star, and today I'm here to tell you guys about my eating disorder story. So this is a little different from any video that I've ever made on my channel, but the Lord has been telling me to share this story for quite a while now, and I actually just didn't share the story. I did try to share the story about 2 years ago, but I was too choked up and I wasn't able to get my point. I wasn't able to tell my story. But I'm back. I'm determined to make this video because I know it can help someone. I didn't really want to share this type of information because no one knows this about me except, of course, some people in my family. And then once before I gave my testimony at church. I have a small church, maybe about 30 members. Other than that, no one knows. I never told anyone. Didn't really want to put it on YouTube, but sometimes your testimony is not really about you. It's about the people that it can help. So I figured I'd just come and share my story. This is a long story and it goes back about 10 years. So going back to childhood, I would say elementary and middle school, I was really slim. So during that time in elementary and middle school, I never paid attention to my weight. Like I ate whatever I want, not like unhealthy, like, you know, picking out or anything, but I always had a big appetite, but I never gained weight up until I hit high school. So in the ninth grade, I started to become really aware of my body, and that's where I noticed that I was a little pudgy in areas that I didn't want to be pudgy in. Like I said, I was never overweight, but I just became aware of my body and I knew that I wanted to lose weight. I wasn't sure how I would do it, but I just started to become interested in losing weight and being skinny and looking good. I want to look good. You know how it is when you're in high school, you're starting to just notice yourself more. So after ninth grade, during that summer, I remember the first time that I had an eating disorder experience, I guess you can call it. We were watching a movie and there was a girl on the TV who was bulimic. She was eating food, purging, and it gave me the idea like, maybe I could try that. Remember, I still had this big appetite. I was eating a lot and I noticed that I was starting to gain weight. So I was like, okay, it's the perfect solution. If I just purge my food, I wouldn't gain the weight. That evening, after watching the movie, I went to the bathroom and I did exactly what I saw on the TV and I tried to, you know, purge my food. But the first time it didn't work, it just, nothing would come up. I kept trying, it wasn't working, so I was really upset. But I didn't give up. You know, days later, I tried it again, and throughout that summer, I just kept trying until finally I was successful. It was my little secret. I would eat and then I would purge, but I wouldn't do it all the time. I was aware of what was considered healthy versus what was considered junk food. So whenever I would eat healthy foods like fruits or vegetables, just anything that I thought was healthy, I would keep it down. But if it was something that I didn't want in my body, or if I felt like I ate a little bit too much, that's when I would purge. I didn't do it a whole bunch. Maybe, if I had to guess, maybe like once a week or like once every other week, just random. Like if it was a birthday party and I ate too much, or like if it was a Friday night and we had pizza, just anything that I felt I didn't want in my body. So remember at the beginning I said it was kind of hard for me to purge. I would like use a toothbrush, put it down my throat. But after binging and purging and kind of getting used to it and learning how to do it better, my body changed. This is where it kind of took a toll for the worse, because I no longer had to make myself purge my food. I no longer was putting my finger down my throat. My body actually just became used to food not staying down. By 11th grade, I didn't even have to, you know, I didn't have to use my fingers or toothbrush or anything to make myself purge. I would just naturally like feel the food in my stomach and I would be able to just like let all my food come out. I'm sorry, this video was really explicit, but I don't know how else to tell it. I'm gonna tell my story exactly how it happened. So you have your esophagus here, and then you have your stomach, and in between that there's a thing called the esophageal sphincter. I hope I'm pronouncing it right, but it's pretty much like this little flap that prevents your food from coming back up after you eat. But if you vomit so much, this little piece that's in the middle gets weak and your food, you'll have heartburn and all that kind of stuff. So that's what happened to me. I was able to purge my food without having to do anything. Like I could just, you know, let my food come up if ever I wanted to. Because it became easier for me to purge, I started to purge more. So all throughout, really leading into 12th grade is where it got really bad. So I spent pretty much majority of my high school being bulimic, and sometimes I would try to stop. I started to notice, like, hey, this is a problem. I don't think you can control this anymore. Something that started out as a game for me, like, oh, this could be fun, I can eat whatever I want. That was my mindset, you know, ninth grade. Toward 11th and 12th grade, I started to see, like, okay, this is a problem, this is not healthy. You know, I wanted to stop, but by then it was out of my control. Well, so I felt it was out of my control. I finally admitted it to my mother. I think that was in the 12th grade. Like, I wrote her a letter, slid it under her door, everything that I was doing. And she came to me like, you have to stop. And I tried to stop on and off. I would try to stop. I would keep relaxing, try and stop. Originally, at the very beginning, my weight was 135. But after doing all that, I got my weight down to the lowest, 114, and I still wanted to lose weight. I was never satisfied. I just always wanted to lose weight. Like, I hated my body. I became obsessed. My anxiety was so bad just doing that, always worried about food. So when I was 17 years old, my mother, because remember I said I admitted it to her, that what I was doing, and she kept on trying to get me to stop and try to help me to stop, but nothing was working. She would smell it on me. Like, she would say, like, I know what you've been doing, I can, like, smell it on you. So yeah, that's disgusting, I know. Eventually, when I graduated high school, I was 17 years old, technically still a minor until I turned 18 that November. She told me that we were going to the doctor, that we would try and speak to them, and she took me to the hospital and I didn't go home. Like, she tricked me, which is, I was so upset with, like, I was so upset with her at the time, because at first, I was asking her for help. I told her what happened, and I kind of wanted help, but eventually, the eating disorder took over, and I didn't want to stop. Like, I enjoyed it. I enjoyed that I was losing all this weight. I enjoyed it. I was starting to like the way I look. You know, I didn't want to stop, and she was the one who was now trying to force me to stop, so it was a constant, like, fight between the two of us. We weren't getting along at that time, because she was trying to, like, take my drug away from me, and, of course, when you're an addict, you're not gonna like that. So she took me to the hospital. I'm thinking that we're just going for a routine visit, and then they locked the doors and they didn't let me go home. And I was just like, I graduated high school, I'm grown, you guys can't force me to stay here. But because I was a minor, you know, she signed me in and said that I had to stay. They admitted me into the hospital, the eating disorder unit at a mental health hospital. And when I went in there, I think I was 114 pounds, but they knew that my original weight, because, you know, from my previous doctor's appointments, my original weight was 135. While I was there, I gained back the 20 pounds. I was there for a month and a half or 2 months. It's like they force fed me without force feeding me. You know that you can't go home if you don't gain the weight. So you're like, I'm stuck here until I do, and I have to do what they say. So in my mind, I was like, faking it, like, okay, I'm gonna gain the weight, I'm gonna do what they say, I'm not gonna purge my food or anything, I'm just gonna listen to all their rules so that I can get out of here, and whenever I get out of here, I'm gonna lose this weight right back. That was my mindset at first, but eventually, as I continued to stay in the hospital, I was like, okay, I really do want to heal, I want to heal myself. By the time I left out of there, I was back up to 135, 136, and I was so uncomfortable because I gained back 20 pounds in 2 months. I would look in the mirror and just cry whenever I got home, because while in the eating disorder hospital, they didn't have mirrors. You're not looking at yourself. So I was gaining the weight and I was following the program. I was doing what they were telling me to do, but I didn't realize that I was gaining as much weight as I was. Like, physically, I didn't know. And then when I went home and I was looking in the mirror, I was like, what the heck? I think that same day that I went home, I relapsed. And then I was like, okay, I won't do it anymore. And eventually, after like 2 weeks, I completely relapsed and was back doing the same thing that I was doing before I went to the hospital. But I was probably worse, because I was like, I was 18 by the time. I was grown and I could do what I want to do. I was on my own. Nobody to tell me what to do. Nobody to force me in the hospital. And by then, my mother, she was just kind of upset with me. And she was like, you know, you're 18. This is up to you. If this is how you want to live your life, you know, that's up to you. She wasn't happy about it, but, you know, what could you do? One thing that actually made it worse is that when I was in the eating disorder, you know, it's a bunch of us adolescents. We're living together for several months. We get close. We start to get to know each other and stuff like that. We're going through the same thing we're all each other has. I made some friends while I was in there, and they tell us that we're not allowed to exchange numbers while in there. You know, you're there to get healed. You're not there to make friends, so they don't want you to meet people who have the same issue as you and then go out on the outside and be a crutch for each other to fall back into the same habits. But that's exactly what I did. I met a friend that was in there, and when we got released, we were same age, same grade and everything. We became really cool, and we actually became worse in our eating disorder by keeping in contact with each other. Like, we would encourage each other to starve ourselves. Like, we would literally be encouraging each other to have an eating disorder, just kind of like, you look good, girl, you're slim, you're losing weight, you can do it. Just literally motivating each other to starve, or to, like, at that point I was started to do more like trying to not eat instead of like binging and purging. I didn't want to do that anymore, so I started to try and starve, but I would still end up binging and purging anyway. We just obsessed over weight together, and it was bad. My eating disorder released right out of control. My anxiety was so bad. I was in just a terrible space in my life, and I just felt like I was out of control. So for my second year of college, I moved to New York that summer. So I was 18, and that was the summer where I was about to turn 19 that November. I moved to New York. I continued to do the same thing. I found a little job. I was working that summer. And, you know, I really wanted to stop. I was talking to my mother a lot. She was just really trying to help me get through it. And she came up with the idea. She said that I should go on a fast and pray, and for the new year, you know, stop, like really put my all in, try and stop. That December, I was like, okay, I'm gonna go on a fast. It was the end of December, new year was about to come, it was about to be 2014, so I was like, okay, this is my chance, it's a new year, fresh start, I'm really gonna do it. So I binged, I had a big binge on the 31st, and I was like, this is, you know, the last time that I'm doing this, like I'm done with this, my eating disorder is done. January 1st came, I went on a fast like my mother told me. I don't remember how long I fasted, but I remember just fasting and praying like in the new year. And that was even, in my mind, risky for me because I went too long without eating. It would make my cravings go up really high, and that would make me binge, which would ultimately make me purge. But this time I was just so determined. I fasted for the new year and never went back. That's the reason why I decided to make this video now too, because the new year just passed. You know, it's January 3rd today, 2019, so that was 2014. 2 days ago makes 5 years clean. And yes, I call it clean because I thought of myself as a drug addict. Like, it was terrible. So yeah, I'm just happy to say that it worked. Fasting and praying, and my mom, I know she was praying with me. I know she prayed for me the whole time as I was going through that, from the time that I told her that I had been struggling with that. I told myself, if I binge this one time, right, and allow myself to gain the weight, maybe that will stop me from continuing to purge. Because, like, when you binge and you purge, it's like you get to eat all this food, but then you don't pay the consequences for it. So throughout the new year, you know, I fasted and everything. And some days I did eat too much, but I just had to tell myself, you have to be uncomfortable for this moment and just deal with the consequences. You decided to binge, so whatever weight I gain, and that's how I took it. So I did have a few times where I binged, but I just was determined, like, I'm not gonna throw up my food. I'm not doing that no more. You know, I'm 19 at this point, it's a new year. So 1 year went, 2 years went, 3 years went, 4 years went, and now here it is, 5 years. And I just thank God, my mother, like, if I had any other mother, I don't know if anybody would have been able to deal with that. But, like, I know that was so hard just to see your child go through that. And thanks, Mom. Even though I fought her, like, 90% of the time, like, I wasn't ready to give up my sickness. It was like a crutch for me. And I fought her all of that time. I still had her praying for me, in my corner, supporting me, telling me that I don't have to live this way. And it really just helps if you have someone in your corner. So if you speak to someone about it, just open up. Just don't keep it a secret between you and yourself, because that's what the devil wants you to, just keep it as a secret and, you know, continue to live in bondage. But you don't have to be in bondage if you're going through this. I'm just so grateful for God that I'm not struggling with that anymore. And I just want to encourage anybody out there who may be struggling with an eating disorder or just struggling accepting your self-image, just try and pray and seek God and really just try and get into your word and rely on God to help deliver you, because I know He can deliver.